Hi, I'm Kim from Chatterbox Quilts. I have several quilt tops. Okay, let's admit it, I have a lot of quilt tops that are sitting around in my studio waiting to be quilted, waiting to be bound, waiting to be able to be used, I suppose, really. In 15 minutes a day, I can calculate and cut binding strips for a quilt top, and I'll show you how you do that. I'm using this particular little, just a little table topper that I have, that I just made recently. Lots of bright colors, lots of fun, quick to make. And I want to make some binding strips for it. I may put a border on, I'm not sure at this point in time, but let's pretend that I'm not going to do a border for it and I just want to do binding. I need to figure out how big this is. And of course, it's not going to be completely square. Nothing I make ever is. So it's approximately, well, let's just say for ease of calculation, 25 inches by... supposedly 25 inches. We're gonna go with 25 by 25 because it's supposed to be a square. So 25 and 25 is 50, right? You do the width times the length, and then you're gonna multiply by 2 to get the entire perimeter of the quilt top that you're talking about. So we're gonna be talking about 100 inches. All right, so this is what I'm gonna use for my binding fabric. This one here, because I think that would look nice on it. And so what I'm going to do, of course, I need to figure out how many binding strips I need to cut from this fabric. And I'm going to have to iron this fabric and get it ready for cutting, of course, as well. But I'm more concerned today with the calculations. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my phone and I'm going to get to my calculator, hopefully. Oh, look at that. And I'm going to take 100 inches because that's what the perimeter was of this particular quilt top. And I'm going to multiply it by 0.0254. Don't ask me where I get this figure from. It's kind of the magic number and it works, so we'll just go with that. If you know what this figure represents, please advise me in the comments below so I'll know for the future. Okay, and it's gonna be 2.54. That was easy with 100, wasn't it? What does that mean? What's 2.54? Well, that's the number of strips I'm going to need to go around this particular project. So I'm not gonna cut 2.5 strips, of course. So what I'm gonna do is whatever figure I get here, I'm gonna round it up. So I'm gonna go with 3 strips. And we'll cut 3 strips from this particular fabric at whatever width you typically do your binding at. I usually use 2.5 inches, but you may use something a little bit less than that. And that is going to give you sufficient binding to go right around this particular quilt once you join the strips together, of course, with mitered seams. And you're going to come out with something like this. Okay, there's 2.5 inches here, and I've joined these with mitered seams. Then I fold them in half and iron them, of course, and it's ready to attach to your quilt top. But what I wanted to show you is when you use a mitered seam on this, it's very difficult to tell where the joins are as opposed to just using a straight seam. So as you can see, even with a striped fabric, not that easy, I can tell by feel, but not that easy from sight really to pick them up quickly. And of course, once they're on the quilt, you're really not going to see them at all. So in 15 minutes a day, I can cut binding strips for a quilt top. You'll want to subscribe to my YouTube channel where you can view all my other videos and tutorials.